May 12th, 2021 is officially the day that the Republican Party as we once knew it died. And yes, I am referring to the fact that Republicans opted to vote Liz Cheney out of her leadership position. Not that I wanted Liz Cheney to be in a leadership position. Not that I think Liz Cheney is a hero or any kind of even decent human being. But what they did on May 12th wasn't just voting out Liz Cheney. What they did was they sent a message to the entire country that we have decided who we are and we're the MAGA party. Even though Trump lost us the House in 2018 and lost us the Senate in 2020, he couldn't win the popular vote in 2016 or in 2020. And also, by the way, another little interesting nugget here, Republicans lost ground in every single special election that took place in this country while Trump was president. That doesn't mean they lost every special election. They lost most of them. But they lost ground in every single special election. So across the board, everything Trump touched became a political loser for the Republican Party. But on May 12th, they stood up and said, "We're with the loser. That is who we are. If you are not with the loser, you gotta go." And this has created a rift within the party that is not healable. It has created a fissure so deep that the Republican Party, I do not believe, is going to bounce back from this. This is it. May 12th was the end. What we thought we knew of the Republican Party is gone. Done. And I'm glad. Good. Because now, Republicans have a choice. And we're seeing that choice play out, right? With the more than 100 former Republican officials saying, if you don't stop with the "we love Trump" crap, we're going to form our own party. Wonderful. Wonderful. Because that means that neither group, the traditional Republicans and the new MAGA Republicans, neither of you are going to have the votes to be able to win elections. So I'm all for it. I'm all for whatever the split is. You know, if you want to separate into two parties with short people and tall people, I'm okay with that too. Whatever you choose to do is fine. Just split. Because you're holding the country back. I don't care whether it's the traditional Republicans who understand that Biden won and aren't afraid to say it, or if it's the MAGA folks living in their alternate reality. Both groups of these people working together or separately are obstructing progress here in the United States. So let the parties die. Let them split. Let them split and then let them split again. I don't care. The Republican Party has outlived its usefulness here in the United States. At one point, it was a good party. But unfortunately, you got to travel back like, what, 170 years almost before you get to the point where they were a good party? And besides, let's not act like political parties haven't come and gone throughout America's history. We have seen major political parties get swept into the ash bin of history. The Federalists, the Whigs, the Democratic Republicans, the Bull Moose Party. All of those parties, by the way, had people serving as president of the United States, so it's not like they were fringe little bitty parties. No, these were massive political parties. Maybe not the infrastructure of them, like with the Bull Moose, but you still got a president. And then they all still disappeared. Maybe it's time for the entire Republican Party to do that too. Maybe they can split. Maybe there'll be a sensible version of it that actually works for progress. I doubt it. But the other thing too is, you know what? While the Republicans are splitting and giving the Democrats all this power, what if the Democratic Party also were to split? I don't know. Then suddenly we have four major parties. Sounds a little more representative, doesn't it? If the Republicans split, I think this is a good time for other third party, smaller parties to emerge and finally spread the power out in this country. That's why this split is such a good thing. It's not just because I despise the Republican Party. That's a big part of it. But it's because splitting the parties is good. But you can't split one without splitting the other, because then the other grabs all the power. So if this one splits, this one has to split. This country actually needs those things to happen. That is what I hope continues to happen. But all I see right now is that this rift, the fissure within the Republican Party, that's not fixable. And as I said, the Republican Party, as we knew it, officially died. Time of death, May 12th, 2021. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel for fresh content every single day of the week. Just smash that subscribe button, and of course, don't forget to like, comment, and share the video.